Hi everyone, I hope you're good. It's been a while since I last posted a video about our weather here in UK HMS. In today's video, I will be showing you how to improve and take stunning photos with your Dji Mini 2 using AEB auto exposure bracketing, MEB manual exposure bracketing, and HDR high dynamic range. And also you can use this technique with your phone or DSLR. I will tell you exactly how to use each one and how to merge and edit those photos afterwards in Photoshop. You can use different software if you wish, like Lightroom, Photomatix, and many more, but I personally like using Photoshop. Now that we are in the air, we will start with AEB. Before we do that, let me take a normal photo so we can compare. Adjust your auto exposure and take your picture. Let's do now the AEB. Go to Photo, then AEB. Some more advanced drones, they got an option to choose 3 or 5 pics, but Dji Mini 2 can do only 3, but that's okay. I will show you after this the MEB, which we will do it manually. So we click and it takes 3 quick pictures with different exposures, and you can see those in your album. The good thing with this is you don't have to worry if it will drift. But the downside, it does it automatically, so we don't got any control of the exposure. With MEB, it might give you more flexibility with exposure, but also it has its downside. Not only you need to manually do every single photo, but you need to realize you are in the sky and slightly wind or drift from the drone, the photos are not going to be aligned. Let me show you the MEB and you can decide. So with manual, you want to get maybe 3 or more exposure. It's up to you. I will go with 5. So your first picture will be the 0.0. Then depending on the area and the time you're flying, you need to get 2 more pictures with overexposed and 2 pictures underexposed. I will go with 2 up, take a picture, and then another 2 and take another picture, and I will do the same with the underexposed. I will go 2 down, take a picture, and another 2. Before I show you how to merge them and how to edit them in Photoshop, I will talk to you about HDR. HDR is similar to AEB, and what that does, it will take the pictures you took and it will merge them into one and adjust it automatically without giving you too much options to manually do some changes. So now with the talking, let's do some work. So guys, we are ready now to edit our photos. I will show you a few different ways. This is 4 days after because I was trying to figure out some things which I wasn't quite sure. And I believe now I got some idea, because remember, this is something new to me also. Whatever I'm learning here, I'm trying to show you, and this is what I'm doing. I will be using Photoshop, as I said, and to be honest, I think it's better to use some other software, but you can still do the job with the Photoshop. So firstly, download your pictures using quick transfer or using your phone on your desktop, but I suggest using your SD card so you can download them as raw on your laptop and have more flexibility to edit them. Open your Photoshop, go to File, Open, and I already sorted my pictures out here. So we will start first with MEB RAW. You get your 5 exposures that we took with the manual exposure bracketing and just press open. It will bring you up to the RAW menu, which what you want to do here is select all your pictures. You can do that by going in the top left corner and pressing the settings here and do select all. Or you can just use Control A and it will select them using Windows, of course. So after you select everything, go again here at the top corner and press Merge to HDR. It will take some time, so be patient with it. But firstly, I will take and explain you some settings after you press Merge to HDR. So here, you got align image and apply auto settings. You always want to have them tick on because that's the best feature of Photoshop. It does a really good job align all the pictures into one. Some people use this feature to align the photos and then upload it to Lightroom and work better, but as I said, I'm sticking into Photoshop. The next option here is the ghost. The ghost is when you have an object moving in your pictures, the ghosting uses the best of its ability to have it into one place and more steady. After you've done your settings here, just press merge. Let's say merge A. This is just an option to save it, nothing important, we're not done yet. So you save it, and it will give you at the bottom of your exposures the picture that is being merged. As you can see here, I got my different exposures, and at the end, it's the merged picture. So here, it's where the magic begins and where the editing begins. So it also changes a few settings here by itself. Usually what I like to do is raise the shadows and lower the highlights. You can press Alt and you can see here better understanding of the highlights. So you lower your highlights, you increase the shadows, you can even go here on the details and play with the sharpening depending on what you like. Also here, now I will leave the saturation, I will go with the vibrance. Some other important settings, it's here on the top. Quickly explaining to you because I don't want to stick on the editing, I'm just showing you how to merge them and you can play around with the settings. So first important setting is the adjustment brush. Press mask here so you can know what are you masking. So let's say I want to mask the sky. You can change also the size, and after you've done that, you can remove this so you can see better about the sky and then play around with the settings. So if I lower this, it only edits the area that we mask. So I'll put it back to normal. And if you want to remove it, you can just press the red dot here, delete, and it will go back to normal. And another good feature is the gradient filter. Again, you can put the mask on so you can see what are you editing. And here, let's say I want to go for the sky. We will remove this so we can see what are we editing. And maybe here I want to increase the blacks or lower the whites, depending on what you want to do. Put some clarity maybe. You get the idea. I'm not going to spend too much time editing here. I just want to show you how to do it. So after you're done and you're happy with the results, you just press maybe open image, because if you press done, you can just save it and it's ready to upload it on your Instagram or Facebook. But by pressing open image, you can do more further edits when it opens back to Photoshop. So I will show you the thing that I was stuck at the beginning, because I couldn't understand why, and I still don't understand why, but if someone knows, please let me know in the comment section. So after your image open to Photoshop, you can change the bits, because bits are the details in this picture. That's the reason I was stuck and I wasn't aware why, but I will tell you what my thoughts are around this subject. So here you got the bits, yeah? If you change to 32 bits, after it converted to 32 bits, which you can see on the top here, if you go to File, Save As, save on your computer, it doesn't give you the option to save it as JPEG. It only gives you this option. And what people was doing is they was putting it to TIFF, download it and save it to their laptop or desktop, and then from there, they was uploading it to Photomatix or Lightroom and they was doing more adjustments there. So if you put it back 16 bits, you get the option for saving it to JPEG. And it's asking you, do you want to merge the layers? You press merge, and after it's done, when it merges to 16 bit, you will get this option here. To look like it was, you can change this one to exposure and gamma, and it goes back to your normal picture. Press OK. And now it converted to 16 bits here on the top, as you can see. And now if we go on our file, save as, save on computer, you will have the option to save it as a JPEG. So let's save it, merge raw JPEG. And now your image is saved, which we'll have a look right now. That looks okay. I could have played a bit with the highlights in the sky, but I got 20 minutes to get ready and go to work, so I don't got too much time editing the picture. But in the raw pictures, you can play around with the settings on the top, adjustment, layers, the mask. You can use the gradient and play with the sky or the highlights. But here you got a lot of details in the trees, in the skies, which usually here will be darker and contrasty, and the sky will be more overexposed. So that's the good with merging pictures. So let me show you the second method really quick. So we go back, we use File, go to Automate, Merge to HDR Pro, High Dynamic Range. When you press that, you will come across this window. You want to press Browse. Let's do this time the AEB, the three picture that the drone took automatically with only three exposures. You select them, press OK. Give it some time because this one will take a bit longer because it does all the work by itself. You can see also here on the background, the layers are being done by themselves. It just reads everything and tries to merge everything together. So when it's done, usually you will not have this window. You will have the 16-bit window, which you can play around with the setting. This doesn't look good right now, but believe me, it will look even better. And on the bottom, you got your three pictures with the different exposures. But when you come to this window, again, you got the remove ghost that I explained to you before. You need to put it into 32 bits. Don't do anything. Use the tick here to go into tone it into ACR, which is the Adobe Camera Raw. Press tone in ACR. So when it opens to the Camera Raw, you will come across this. Don't worry about it. The settings are here and we are working it into 32 bits. So we got a lot more detail to play around with it. What I like, I'll do auto again. Shadows, highlights, a bit of vibrance. Go to details, put some sharpening. Not too much, it will look like a cartoon later on. So let's say we're happy with this, we press OK. Here it's also, again, I was stuck because now this was 32 bits, but whenever it was going into the Photoshop, it was going to 16 bits and I couldn't understand why. I was losing the quality and everything. But here you got, again, 16 bit, but it looks the same for me. And now we can save it. So let's compare all three photos, the normal, the AEB and the MEB. And the normal, I didn't done any edits, it's just from the drone as it is. So here we got the normal picture, the MEB, which we merge and edit using the raw feature, and the AEB, which we use the automate and three exposures. So as you can see, that's a huge difference. Even without edits, Here you got more details in the trees and in the sky. Here it's okay, I didn't play enough with it, but the MEB, I think it's better to use because you get more details. And this is the normal one. Huge difference, guys, and this is it. I think I will be late for my work, so I hope I didn't forget anything. I tried to be as clear as possible to help you out, improve your photos in a different level, and with this method you can use it with your drone, with your phone and your DSLR. So that's it, guys, for the video. If anything I missed out or done something wrong, please share your knowledge down to the comment section, because I'm still also learning. But this is my way, this is how I will do it. And yes, I know you can use a different software which will give you more flexibility, and as I mentioned, maybe you can download it as a TIFF, 32 bits, and then export that to Lightroom, Photomatix, or whatever software you wish. So guys, thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.